Welcome back to the Chronicles of the Drapery Apprentice. Today, we're draping a ceiling, and we're doing it all by ourselves without our TO.
This is a big project, and I don't know how it's going to turn out, but you know what? You gotta be brave to suck at something new to get good later on.
Okay, back to business. So what I'm doing here is I'm creating the base.
You gotta do a little bit of math, get the measurements of the room and how many yards of fabric that you're going to need.
So I had to cut 12 of these by 10 feet.
And then once they're all cut, you can start pleating around the base.
Now I'm gonna slow it down here so you can take a better look at the pleats because I wanna explain this enough to where you guys can try to do too.
So this is what they look like. These are called pinch pleats and you wanna keep them pretty tiny and they have to be the same size all the way around. So you pinch, staple, pinch, staple, pinch, staple. And as I'm going around, I'm making sure that the fabric is following the circle.
Well, actually what you're seeing here is when I fucked up and I didn't do that and then I had to rip them all up.
Yeah, you see that? That's no good. That's no good. This is when I found out that this fabric rips really easily.
Yeah, fucking up sucks.
But as my TO says, it's better to fuck up and start over than fuck up and get all the way down to the project and be like, oops, I should have not fucked up.
So we did it again, and yes, look how nice. That's the way it's supposed to look.
And while we're here, I'll show you how to do a pinch pleat. So you just kind of gather a little pinch.
Toshi, shut the fuck up!
Yeah, this is gonna require some patience because this took me like 3 days.
Then you take all the fabric and you put it through the hoop just like this.
Remember how I taught you how to pleat the edges? Whoopsie, I folded them the wrong way, so I had to go back to each edge and fix it.
Then you gotta get yourself a man. A man with long arms, a long, long man to put that thing up there.
Normally I say, you don't need a man, girl, but I love this man and this man helps me with all of my projects. And honestly, this is the hardest part of the project because all the fabric up there is really, really heavy and you gotta make sure that you screw it into either some studs or get some anchors, I don't know, something like that.
Voila, there she is.
This is when you put your corners up, which is my favorite part. Now, before you do your pleating, you have to take each corner of the fabric and staple it to the wall around the ceiling.
And as I was doing this, I realized, oops, I fucked up some more. So then I had to call my TO for help.
So what do you think?
I think your bath might have been a little bit off somewhere.
Why are you looking at me like that?
To fix this, we have to start over there.
So then you guessed it. We had to take it down and start all over again.
Well, we didn't have to take down the base, which was nice.
Tio was able to adjust the placement for me. There's a little bit of overlap, so it's not perfect, but, you know, I think I did a pretty good job.